And now you never thought you'd get to see it. You never thought we'd get here. I swore I'd never come back again to Comic-Con.
How did they let you in here? Who let you in here?
You did.
Who let you?
You did. Oh. You did.
It's Anthony Del Call, finally, and Conor McCreery of Kill Shakespeare. Thank you for the pass.
How did he get in here?
I don't know. It wasn't me. It wasn't me.
He slept his way to the top, okay? All right. Okay. All right.
Steven, that's what I like about you. You like to stick with the classics.
That's
you.
one way.
All about Steve. Then.
Yes, actually, but you know, look at this. You've got a corner booth. These guys, you're
coming up, man. This is like prime real estate.
I know, and you're like so hard to get a hold of. I spent a whole day trying to find him at Toronto, as you may remember. This is all down on tape.
I had to fly away from Tucson just to get away from him.
Right, right. And in Tucson,
I missed all the films. I missed all the films we were supposed to.
But I bet you've caught up.
Some of them.
Well, anyway.
At least the buzz. I know the buzz.
All right. Okay. And you've become, since I last saw you, the pop culture vultures. Is this true?
That is true. We've been fortunate enough. After our debut in the Stephen Holt Show, which catapulted our reputation, our Q factor, to a new level, we've been asked by a local... well, Q factor can stand for many things. We actually now do a spot on global TV back home in Toronto doing pop culture stuff. Stephen, a true artist does not take money. No, we don't get paid, but we would. We're very
happy. All right, we're all still in the same boat.
Are we getting paid for this interview?
No. Anyway. But you're getting...
I got my hopes up there for a moment.
Well, the only person making money here today is Kevin. Anyway, tell us what's happened with Kill Shakespeare since last I saw you. Have announcements and
t-shirts and
merchandise?
Yeah, of course. Well, I mean, there's a couple cool things. One is at the show, we're making our American Comic-Con debut of the live stage reading.
Oh, congratulations. So, yeah. Seriously.
Thank you very much. Yeah, so we've taken Kill Shakespeare
Which is why you were in Tucson.
Yeah, we've taken from the pages of the comic book, and now it's on stage. So it's a live stage reading. We take all the images from the comic book that Andy Belanger, our artist, did. We project them up on a screen, and we have actors this weekend for a theater company, Gideon Productions. They do the dialogue, they do the sound effects, they do the music right there. So it's a comic
book. And I'm not in it?
Steven, your schedule is so busy. Yeah. I mean, we contacted your agent, your manager.
That's why you couldn't reach me.
Well, okay, yeah. I mean, we kept getting a dial tone, but I thought that was your canny way of making us raise the price. Yeah.
I wanted to. You promised me I would play Falstaff, in honor of which I fell on the bus. Kevin screaming, "Are you all right? Are you all right?" And I said, "Well, I'm Falstaff, you know." That's getting into the part. Anyway, look at all this incredible stuff, all these developments. This is so cute. We have to hold this up.
Yes.
You have done this. I'm not kidding you. I'm not kidding you. There was a kid and his mother who will be preceding you on the show. We filmed them talking about this T-shirt.
Oh, really?
They were fans. They said, "Oh, you know them? You know them?" I was like, "Oh, God, now what?" All right.
We do have great fans. I've actually been asked by a pair of our fans in Halifax to preside over their renewal of vows. So I will become the chaplain. Hopefully it'll be a little less tragedy than a lot of the Shakespearean plays that involve chaplains.
Well, as long as it's not like Romeo and Juliet and you're trying to, you know, pass on messages that are...
I promise nothing.
You're announcing this is your fallback career now.
Yeah, my fallback career is I'm a step-in chaplain. Yeah, exactly. I was raised Roman Catholic.
Me too. That's a good idea. All redheads are. It's a good place to be.
Are you redhead?
Well.
Hey now. Let's not speak ill of the gingers.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Steven,
yeah. Just call me Ginger. Yeah. I know. And
I can't get away from you guys.
You've got announcements?
Yes, we actually officially made the announcement, it becomes official this weekend. We're going to continue on Kill Shakespeare. So we're going to do another 5 issues, which will culminate in a 3rd book, and that'll be released in February of next year.
Why am I not surprised?
The Tide of Blood. Look for it in comic shops in February. Tide of Blood.
I like that. And also, I have to mention, you guys had the incredible good luck of going to England this year, right?
Oh,
am I right?
Did I
was I seeing things on YouTube?
It was a jolly good time. Jolly good time.
And you were standing
with a really bad accent.
And you were in. Well, I'll come back from London. Yes, if I. Just slight. You know, say aunt and like half
Madonna.
And boss.
Like Madonna.
Yeah,
you
Madonna.
You almost sound like an honorary Canadian, actually, at that point.
That's true, actually. You are an honorary Canadian at this point.
I know. Everyone thinks I'm Canadian.
All you have to do is wear a Via Trade ball cap.
I wear it all the time. Oh, God, I love this T-shirt.
Well, I mean, I don't know, Stephen. We don't want to impinge upon your journalistic credibility, but we would be honored. We would be honored if you would be willing to wear and to take a Kill Shakespeare T-shirt.
All right, let's see if it fits. All right, here.
Drum roll, please.
Yeah. Drum roll, please.
Oh, my God. This is the comic Lotsy part here. All right, let's see. Am I going to be able to make
it? Oh, yeah, here it goes. Here it goes.
Take the hat off.
And maybe not over the best in the future.
Yeah.
The best does not do the T-shirt any favors.
No.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, but it fits. Oh, yeah. It fits. There you go. Hey!
Yes!
How do you like that?
And that's called show business. Okay. All right. And now, have we covered everything? Oh, well, your marriage, of course.
Yes. Yeah, I've been really fortunate. I married my fiance, the wonderful, beautiful, talented Crystal Luxmore. I love you, honey.
You're the bearer of the ring, and now you're Frodo.
I am, except it kind of feels like she tossed me into Mount Doom.
She does what?
It kind of felt like she tossed me into Mount Doom. But yeah, no, so we got married.
I thought you said Mountain Dew. I didn't know what was going on. All right.
It's a comic reference.
Now I'm thirsty.
Now I'm thirsty, and it's time to talk about the Oscars, because since I, you know, encouraged them and taught them everything they know, they've become predictors on a network in Canada. I'm still here in New York, but anyway.
I think we should do some sort of pool this year. Put money down on it. We'll do a pool to see who can predict.
Now that wouldn't work because I have no money. But anyway, let's sit down.
We'll do a dinner at your favorite place.
All right. Well, I thought we were going there later. But anyway, let's just sit down and talk about Oscars.
Sure,
Oscars. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.